In this video, I want to talk about the sacral vertebra, and we'll throw in the coccygeal vertebra at the same time. Remember, the sacrum was made originally from five different vertebral bones that fused to form one sacrum. And we really still have the bodies of the vertebra, and we still have the transverse processes of the vertebra. Those transverse processes just are very large, and they have fused together to form what we call the ala, or the wing of the sacrum. Remember, between adjacent vertebra, we had an opening called an intervertebral foramen. Well, in the sacrum, we still see those intervertebral foramen. However, now we do not call them intervertebral foramen. We call them pelvic or sacral foramina. If they enter into the pelvic side of the cavity, they are known as pelvic or anterior sacral foramina. If they exit through the posterior sacrum, we call them dorsal sacral foramina. So again, we have the bodies, they are fused, and we have the transverse processes, which are fused to make the sacral ala. And we have transverse lines where you can imagine we used to have the intervertebral discs, but those have ossified as well to form the one large sacrum. Now, the very first sacral vertebra has a little lip that sticks off of the upper portion into the pelvis. That region is known as the sacral promontory. On a lateral view of the pelvis, we can see the area where it will articulate with the ilium of the os coxa to form our sacroiliac joint. Posteriorly, we do not see spinous processes anymore. The spinous processes have fused to form what we call the median sacral crest. I didn't talk about it before, but when we take all of the vertebral foramen of the various vertebrae and line them up in the vertebral column, they form what is called the vertebral canal. In the sacrum, we do not have a vertebral canal. We line up that vertebral canal and fuse it, and it is then known as the sacral canal, coming in here, and exiting at the bottom, we have what is called the sacral hiatus. So those are the bones of the sacrum. Then below the sacrum, we have the four bones of the coccyx. They fuse to form one bone. There is only one coccygeal nerve, so we do not need to have an intervertebral foramen. And for the most part, we don't talk about the various features of the coccyx other than they are four fused bones. So I'm not going to point out anything about bodies, transverse processes, lamina. So sacrum versus the coccyx.